Yo, it's good YouTube. Today it's gonna be a short video for you guys. I'm just sharing with you guys this free code that I have over here. I'm gonna leave the code sandbox in the description if you want to use the code for this. And basically, this is like the title. It says it just plays the Quran on click in MP3 and highlights it. So if you want to play a text and match that to the MP3 file while you're playing it and highlight it, this is the tutorial you need. All right. So let me just show you an example.
والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث.
So basically, let me just explain to you how I'm able to do this. We have one MP3 file, alright? So let me just close up these styles. We just have some styles over here that we are gonna need actually later on. Let me just show you why we're gonna need that later on. Just some header text and just some small text because this was a Stack Overflow question. Alright? So let's get back to here and just a divider. And just some comments over here that I could remove later, but let me show you what we basically need. All right, we have the audio over here, and we just need the ID, and we need the source, and we also need this function. So just make a function and call it whatever you want. You can make it play and loop through text. You don't have to use Quran text, but for now I'm just using the Quran example. And for hovering, can see over here if you want to play it with hovering, and it does not work if we get off the hovering with this logic over here on mouse over. All right, this attribute over here, and we have just some spans that it's gonna have each and every verse. All right, you don't have to mention each and every verse, but you need to mention that on click in each text file, in each text over here, each panel here, I'm sorry. We just need to mention that the function to play and loop if you wanna play it and loop from anywhere. But we could remove this and just make it start from here if you want to, because the logic messes up a little bit if we start it from here because it's done manually. Let me explain to you. Alright, so if you got that HTML tag done, let me just show you the JavaScript itself. Alright, so all of this is not necessary. We just need this, the play and loop through Quran text, this function, which basically I have a const over here that I got the document ID al-duha, which is basically the audio file. Let me just show you that. If you go into the audio file, and you're gonna find the ID over here. This is the ID. And I just got the document ID over here, and then I just did dot play over here, and dot play over here basically is just a way in JavaScript that you could play MP3 files by just pressing on it. All right, the pause function does not work, but we have also something that a loop over here that we're gonna do. This logic I adapted from the question answer over here. I had somebody posted a question. I cannot find it though. Like I'm trying to find the question, but I think the person self removed it. However, that's what I'm trying to say. This logic I didn't develop, like this part of this logic I didn't develop myself. I just adapted it. I had another person that added this logic over here for this for loop, but everything else in the project I made except this area of this project, like basically these lines of code, these around like 30 lines of code over here. I did not write these 30 lines of code, somebody else did. So thanks to him and thanks to God for basically just providing this. All right, so we got a timing array over here, and basically this timing array over here, We're just doing a durations over here const as well. That's basically mapping over the timing that we have over here. That's done in millisecond. So we're basically matching the text over here with the class of CSS3 to highlight with the for loop over here. So basically on click, we wanted to basically toggle the highlight class in the CSS3 file on in the top of the page over here, as you could see. And finally, we're just doing this for loop over here with a for each loop. And it's got a child array, which is basically just the Quran container, the container div that we have over here. Just 1 second, let me get that. All right, where it is. Let me just close these tiles. And here it is. This is just the whole container. This is basically just looping over the whole container, this part of the code. We're just looping over the spans that are in the code, basically, guys. All right. And also over the audio. So again, how we matching, how these are matched is basically due to this logic over here. We're mapping the timing to the stop and start. So basically, if the reader, like for example, is reading an MP3 file, and this reader, like for example, is reading hello from second zero to second one, you need to mention that here in milliseconds. So that's why that's in 1000 and like 3000. This is basically like second number one and this is second number three. So 3 seconds over here, 3 seconds over here, and we're stopping at 4 seconds. So if the reader takes like 1 second to read this, that is what we're doing. As you can see, I'm just ignoring the first one because the reader does not read it in the MP3 file I have over here. And then this text area needs just 1 second to be written. That's why I mentioned 1 second. And this needs around 2 seconds. So that's why I mentioned from 1 second to 3 seconds. And so on and so forth until I ended the verses for this ayah over here, or surah. All right. So basically, this is how you loop over the text and play the MP3 file with it in a vanilla JavaScript environment. All right. So this is pretty much it. I'm not gonna make this video any more longer. Comment and like, subscribe. And again, you could use this logic with any text file. You don't need to use the Quran file. You could use whatever file you want. This is just for demonstration and for the question of Stack Overflow. Just let me know, you guys, if you like this video, and if you'd like to see more short videos like this, comment and like and subscribe. This was AngoEDU, and I will see you guys in the next video. And please check out the code sandbox in the description. I have this code for free if you want to use it for yourself, but please try to learn from it. And if you have a better way to do this, please mention it in the description or in the please mention it in the comments. It would be greatly appreciated for anybody that would be able to help this to do this like automatically or do this in a better way. That would be much appreciated. All right, comment and like, subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video.